Hey guys, let's jump straight in. So I'm going to start with Hourglass Veil Mineral Primer. This one is great. It really does lock in your foundation day and night, so you don't have to worry about it coming off when you're celebrating long into the night. Then I'm going to use the Cover FX Custom Cover Drops in G40. These are my favorite. I feel like New Year's is that kind of event where you use all of your favorite products. I don't really experiment on days like these. I use what I know will look good and will give the finish and the result that I want. So I'm using a smaller brush to get in and around my eyes just to make sure that all of the fair skin underneath is covered up. Now I'm using the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer underneath the eyes, and with a beauty blender I'm going to be kind of blending that out. I like to use a beauty blender for this because I feel like with this particular concealer, if you use a brush, it's just way too full coverage, especially underneath the eyes. The beauty blender absorbs some, which makes it look more natural. Next I'm using the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in Light to set that in place. A lot of this will be generally what I do day to day just because, you know, I want to use products that I know are going to look good, so this is just another one of those. And then I like to apply that on my eyelids as well to prevent creasing and as an eyeshadow base pretty much. Next I'm using the Laura Mercier Loose Translucent Powder to set my face. This is a standard one and of course depends on your preferences in terms of if you like your foundation looking matte or dewy. I prefer a matte finish, and then spraying some face mist over the top, which you'll see here, to kind of get rid of that matte dusty powdery look and bringing some life back into the skin. Plus of course powdering your makeup makes it last a million times longer in my experience anyway. This is the Hoola Bronzer by Benefit. I'm going to contour my cheekbones and on my forehead. I only really contour these days if I have, you know, an event or a special occasion, so that's why I'm doing it now. This is the NARS Blush in Deep Throat, I believe. Awkward. And I'm just dusting that over my cheeks and then using the Tartas Pro Glow palette and this shade here to highlight. This wasn't as highly pigmented as I had hoped or expected it to be, so I did go in quite a lot to, you know, build up the intensity down the bridge of my nose and on my Cupid's bow. Then I'm going to go in and fill in my eyebrows with my trusty Makeup Store Premium Tri-Brow in Blonde and my Dose of Colors Winged Liner Brush. I love this brush, it's amazing. It's very thin, so you get a really like clean, crisp line and you can get a lot of precision with that brush. And of course it has a spoolie on the end, which is really handy as well. Then I'm going to use the Makeup Store Clear Brow Gel to set them in place. Of course, on any day, it doesn't matter where I'm going, I want my brows to be locked in like cement. They are not moving, not even if it's like a cyclone or a hurricane. No wind can. What am I talking about? No wind can affect them. Next I'm using the Chloe X Ciate Pretty Fun Feelers palette. This is amazing. Chloe, you killed it. You killed it. It's the most beautiful range of colors. I love this top row. Very me. Nice warm tones. Amazing for the you know, crease as a transition color. So I'm just working this up. Basically different shades of brown getting darker and darker and using a smaller brush as I get closer into the crease. As you can see, this brush here has, you can't really see actually, but it's quite like a tapered blending brush. It's not like a big fluffy one. And so it just gives us more precision in the crease. Next, I'm using the Tarte Shape Tape and a concealer, flat concealer brush to do this little, you know, very very trendy technique that everyone seems to be doing. I thought I'd give it a go. It's just that kind of concealer on the first, I'd say, half of the inner eyelid, which kind of looks like you have a cut crease. It's a lot easier than a cut crease because you're going over eyeshadows that are already there, so you're not having to like, anyway, I'm rambling. Next, I'm going to apply some eyeshadow in the outer corner of my eyelid and then blend that over the concealer just to make a nice gradient. This is the ColourPop Cream Shadow and I'm going to place that over the concealer. This color isn't that fabulous on its own, so I am going to use it as a base. You can still, of course, use the concealer as a base, but by this point mine had pretty much set, so it wasn't tacky enough to hold the next product securely in place. Then I'm going to go in with the Urban Decay Liquid Moon Dust product. This is like kind of like liquid glitter almost. There is some fallout, so just be careful. I didn't realize that there would be, so I was not prepared. But anyway, I'm just applying that straight over the concealer and then the cream shadow. So just making sure that it kind of blends really nicely into the eyeshadow on the outer corner of your eye. Next is the Darkest Shadow Pencil from Makeup Store. I'm just going to create a really basic thin line on my upper lash line. I'm not going to create a wing this time. I just want it to be a nice kind of blown out smoky eye. And I'm going to bring this down into my inner corner to create that nice kind of cat eye effect. And also tight lining and lining my waterline. This will kind of enclose the eyes, but I feel like it makes it nice and like sexy and smoky, especially for New Year's Eve. Just adds that extra bit of depth and drama. Now I'm using a small flat shader brush from Sigma to blend some eyeshadow underneath the eyes to join it up to the top, basically using the same eyeshadows in the same order, just underneath the lower lash line. This is the Urban Decay Perversion Mascara. This is great, just a little forewarning that it does, if you're sweaty or you have really oily eyelids, it will transfer to your eyelids. I probably should have used a different one for this purpose for New Year's, but I didn't think about it until after. So maybe a waterproof or your favorite trusty non-transferring mascara will do the job perfectly. As you can see, I'm applying to my lower lashes as well and using some lashes from this brand. I don't know how to pronounce it, so I'm not gonna try. Just popping those straight on. I'm using the Duo Lash Adhesive, strip the brush on lash adhesive, I think it's called, which is really, really great. This is the Tarte Lip Paint, I think it's called. It's a beautiful color. I love the color, but it's just too drying on my lips. So I had to go in after this with the Anastasia Lip Gloss in Butterscotch, which just brought some moisture back into my lips. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you have an amazing new year and have a really fun end of 2016. Be safe, and I love you all so much. Bye!